But as Ovid succumbed to viral infection and co-celebrated a famous victory, Cram started to make his plans.
Seb was, didn't race much after the final in LA. I came back and was really just beginning to get into shape as I went to LA. So when I came back, I was really hungry to go and run some races. And that was when I really first was pushed into the, right, Steve, we've got pacemakers and this is... And I had two or three disappointments that year, running personal bests, you know, knocking one or one half second off a personal best and then walking into the press box and everyone saying, you must be really disappointed with that, you know, because you'd missed the world record by 0.3 or something. And I guess that kind of made me think, yeah, I'd really like to lay this one to rest. I'd really like to get a world record under my belt just to prove that I can do it.
In July 85, the first record arrived, a 1,500 metres triumph in Nice. 11 days later, Cram came to Oslo.
The world record was something which I knew I was capable of, but on that night wasn't an issue as far as I was concerned. The main criteria for me was, you know, beat Seb at all costs.
And Kohler is beaten. And Kohler relaxes, he knows that Cram is away and gone. And the world champion, the European champion, the Commonwealth champion, the world record holder at 1,500 metres, majestically comes striding away. This time, is it to crack the world record? Yes, it is. 3:46.3. Gonzalez second, Coe third, Scott fourth.
Fear of defeat is a much greater spur than the fear of the clock ticking by a couple of seconds too fast. You know, it's a much greater fear. And that's what drives you on to push harder and to run faster. I remember finishing the race and I kept saying to everybody, it can't be 3:46, you know, I'm not tired, you know. I could. And then, of course, your big mouth starts going and you go in the press conference and you say, oh, yeah, I can run 3:44, no problem, you know. And you never, ever get anywhere near it again.
But one man got near. His name is Noureddine Morsali. And in the Italian town of Rieti in September 93, the young Algerian dipped beneath 3:45 to destroy a record which had stood for 8 years.
3:46.32 da battere, primato del mondo.
Grande.
3:44.38. Qui non c'è vento che tenga. Grande primato del mondo ha cancellato Steve Cram.
I wasn't feeling tired, you know. I felt like I did save some energy left in my body, and also it was maybe hard, you know, because I ran last 600 by myself. And that's why maybe my time was 3:44. If I did have pace until maybe 1,200, I should maybe run 3:42.
But there is nobody capable of staying with him. Nobody who can test his awesome talent. For the moment, Morsali stands alone.
You have to really love what you are doing if you want to be great. You know, it's not easy to run 3:44. You know, it's very, very hard. You have to be very, very tough. And, you know, if you want something, you know, with hard work, you can do it, I think.
The young man expresses the old values of stern sacrifice and bold vision. They are also the values of the athlete who once lowered a barrier on a cool spring evening in Oxford and set his successors a terrifying task.
The margin by which the mile record is broken will get less and less as time goes on, and I think the time they will approach is something like 3:30.
3:30. Well, thank you, Roger Bannister. Tonight, you've seen some of the greatest mile races ever. I hope they thrilled you as much as they did me. Cheerio.